Welcome to the second hour of This Morning. Here are today's headlines. In a closed-door meeting briefing with President Moon Jae-in yesterday, Finance Minister Hong Nam-ki reported that South Korea's economic growth will turn positive in the third quarter thanks to an uptick in exports and the government's fourth supplementary budget. In response, President Moon asked the finance minister to take all necessary efforts to make South Korea a successful economic model following its success of K-quarantine efforts against COVID-19. Earlier this week, President Moon commented that, quote, now is the golden time for an economic recovery and stressed the importance of pan-governmental efforts to enhance the vigor of South Korea's economy. The Board of Audit and Inspection of Korea has found that the economic feasibility study conducted in 2018 to determine its early shutdown unreasonable in its audit of Wolsung Nuclear Power Plant Unit 1. But the board limited its scope of the audit to economic feasibility only and stated the audit cannot be seen as a comprehensive feasibility assessment of the decision to immediately suspend the plant's operations. The Ministry of Trade, Industry and Energy said the audit results will not impact its energy policy direction since no problem has been found regarding the early shutdown decision in consideration of not just economic feasibility, but also many other factors such as safety and resident acceptance. Russia's military intelligence service, GRU, was revealed to have conducted malicious cyber attacks against a wide range of networks and systems across the world, including the 2018 Pyeongchang Winter Olympics and Paralympic Games. In a joint investigation with U.S. intelligence agencies, the U.K. National Cybersecurity Center has found the GRU's cyber unit, 74455, targeted the Winter Olympics opening ceremony, attempting to disguise itself as North Korean and Chinese hackers. The Russians also targeted the now postponed Summer Olympics in Tokyo, Ukraine's electricity grids, and French President Emmanuel Macron's party before his election. Finally, a delivery person in his 40s has committed suicide, leaving a three-page will outlining the abuses committed against him and other drivers by his company, Logen. In the letter, he said the company refused to provide air conditioning and forced him to load and unload in the scorching heat while paying him less than 2 million won a month and threatened to sue him for damage compensation when he told them he wanted to quit. The Logen branch he worked at said it was his responsibility to find his replacements as he had agreed on the labor contract and denied ever threatening or abusing him. And you can listen to these headlines once again on our YouTube channel by searching TBS EFM. Once there, you'll get a script of the headlines and subtitles as well. Coming up next, a discussion on the implications of the U.S. presidential election on the Asian American community, followed by a look into the various misinformation going about the election as well as COVID-19.